गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज कंपनी अकाउंट्स फॉर 12th कॉमर्स अकाउंटेंसी। आवर टॉपिक एज पर द चैप्टर 6 कंपनी अकाउंट्स द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ कंपनीज बैलेंस शीट। इन दिस टॉपिक यू जस्ट कम टू नो दैट हाउ द कंपनीज बैलेंस शीट आर टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड, डेटेड ऑन 22 जून 2020. See, the format of the company's balance sheet is floating on the screen. Here, the company's balance sheet format as per Schedule 3 Company Act 2013 is given to you, in which how the share capital is to be disclosed is mentioned to you. See, this extract of the balance sheet that is showing here with the columns particulars, note number, amount of current year and amount of previous year. This format is shown in the vertical form. Earlier to this, you prepared the balance sheet in 11th class in case of sole trade and partnership, and that is the balance sheet is to be shown in horizontal form. But here it is to be shown in vertical. What does it mean? It means the items are shown step by step, like the first column is particular, note number, and then the amount of both of the year is to be shown. You have to shown all the items turn by turn. First of all, equities and liabilities are given here, then assets are given under it. We will discuss the extract of the share capital in this, because this chapter is related to the accounting treatment of share capital. See, the shareholder fund are to be shown under the equities and liability, which consists of the share capital, reserve and surplus, and money received against share warrant. The point C, money against share warrant, is not to be evaluated in 12th class. From practical point of view, you have to learn only it from the theory point of view. Now, the share capital and reserve and surplus, the amount of both of these items are to be prepared in notes to accounts. See, in the next in this slide we just come to know that how the notes to account is to be prepared. In this, the share capital is to be divided in different types, that is your authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital. These headings are given in the bold letters which are floating on the screen. You have to show the amount of these capital. First of all, the authorized capital. Authorized capital means whatever the registered or the nominal capital here. It is to be shown in the balance sheet and closed by double line. You can see in the third column of the amount. If the company is issuing equity as well as preference share, the both of the number of share multiplied by each value per share is to be shown here, and then the total amount is to be shown in the last column. Then whatever the amount is issued by the company, it is not necessary that whatever the amount is to be authorized or the registered by the company is to be issued by the company in 1 year. Company can issue its number of shares in all over its company life anytime. Suppose the company have the authorized capital of rupees 1 lakh and issued 15,000 shares only. What is to be done in that case? In authorized capital, the total amount is to be shown 1 lakh shares multiplied by 10. But in case of issued capital, the value issued, that is 50,000 shares multiplied by 10. Suppose subscribed capital means the shares applied by the company are complete, and company also called the complete 10 rupee from the public, then it is shown under the subscribed capital under the heading subscribed and fully paid up capital. Same again, the equity and preference share are to be shown. Whatever the number of shares subscribed by the shareholder multiply by value per share. After that, the heading is shown on the screen, subscribed but not fully paid up capital. The very important concept from board examination, from the point of view of chapter as well. Whatever, let it be, the company has not subscribed the complete number of shares, whether company subscribed the 40,000 or 30,000, whatever, not equivalent to issue. It is to be shown under this heading. Or sometimes this happen like the company has 10 rupee per share and company called rupees 6 in particular accounting year, then it is partially paid up and capital. It means it is not fully paid up capital. Then it is shown under the heading subscribed but not fully paid up capital. I'll make it more clear in the upcoming examples as well. And if there are any calls in areas, whether it is on the shares that are holded by the directors or officers of the company or any other shares, it is to be deducted and forfeited shares are to be added. In this way, the net amount of subscribed capital is to be shown in the balance sheet. Now, let's come to the journal entry. How the journal entries are to be done. When the company receives application, so entry on receiving the application is to be done, that is your bank account debit to share application account. Whatever the number of shares received by the company, it is to be multiplied application per share, not the share value per share. The number of shares of the company issued multiplied by application per share. Let it be a company called the amount of rupees 2 on application or whatever it is to be multiplied that number of per share. I explained the concept of application allotment and calls in my previous videos. If you have any doubt, you can see the previous videos and the concept will be recalled by you. Then the entry on allotment, what is to be done? First of all, the share application is to be due. It is transferred from share application account to share capital account. At this time, the entry will become share application account debit to share capital account. First entry, when we receive the application money. Second entry, when we receive the share capital. Next, after receiving the share application, whatever the entries is to be done, it is related to the allotment. And if the number of shares, if the public applied for more number of shares than the issued, then money refunded to them. The entry for refunding the money is to be done. The first entry floating on the screen, that is share application account debit to bank account. Then allotment is made by the company. The entry will become share allotment account debit to share capital account. And when the allotment money received, the entry will become bank account debit to share allotment. After that, calls are to be made and the entry is to be done. Share first call to share capital for the entry of due of first call. Then bank account debit to share first call for the money receiving for first call. Then the second call due entry, share second call account debit to share capital account, and then the second call money received bank account debit to share second call. In this way, the entry of due as well as received are to be passed. Let's do illustration number one and the concept will be more clear to you practically. In the illustration one, it is given the authorized capital of Ruchi Limited is rupees 50 lakh divided into 50,000 shares of rupees 100 each. Out of these, the company issued 30,000 equity shares for subscribe to the public. The public applied for 27,000 shares. I'm repeating the statement. Ruchi Limited has authorized capital of rupee 50 lakh divided into 50,000 equity shares. Now look at the notes to account. Parallel to this, in the answer, in solution, here the share capital is given to us, that is 50,000 share of rupees 100 each, marked by double line, it is 50 lakh and closed it. Then the issued capital given in second line, 30,000. The next item in notes to account is to be shown 30,000 equity share of 100 each, that will be 30 lakh. In the next case, 27,000 equity share that are subscribed and money all is fully received. It means it is subscribed and fully paid up capital. 27,000 shares multiplied by 100, 27 lakh. The amount of the capital 27 lakhs is to be shown in the share capital under the shareholder fund in the balance sheet. Here the extract of the balance sheet of Ruchi Limited is given to you, and this is the amount is to be shown in the company's balance sheet. What is the amount? Subscribed and fully paid up amount, because the all money is duly received. So in this way we have to do the question. Definitely you will get the 3-mark question for the preparation of these kind of extract of the company's balance sheet in your exam. Let's do the example number. Let's see illustration number 2. New Buy Limited was registered with the authorized capital of rupees 5 lakh divided into 50,000 share of 10 each. Since the company was in robust shape, the company decided to offer to the public for subscription of rupees 30,000 shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 20 per share. Application for 28,000 shares were received and the allotment was made to the applicants. All calls were made and duly received except the final call of rupees 2 per share on 200 share. Show the share capital in the company's balance sheet of New Buy Limited as per the Schedule 3, Company Act 2013. Also prepare the notes to account for the same. So in the first line, the authorized capital of rupees 5 lakh is given to you. In the notes to account, you have to show the value of 50,000 equity share of 10 each, that is shown as authorized capital. In the third line, 30,000 equity share that is offered to the public, means issued to public, are to be shown. 30,000 into 10. In the next, it is given application for 28,000 shares were received. It means the subscribed number of share 28,000. Out of that, all the calls were made except 200, final call on 200 shares. It means subscribed and fully paid up shares means the share who paid the full amount, those are 27,800 shares. 28,000 minus 200 shares. 2,78,000 is subscribed and fully paid up by the company. After that, 200 shares are of 10 each, that they are due to receive 2,000, but 200 share has not paid the money, that will be deducted as calls in arrear. The net amount is to be shown of about 200 share is 1,600. So the net amount of subscribed capital will become subscribed and fully paid up 2,78,000, and subscribed but not fully paid up, that will be 1,600. All in all, the total amount is to be shown in the share capital is 2,79,000 in company's balance sheet. Thank you. Have a nice day.